To keep crew members alive, we need common resources. Common resources increase either through production at base camp or by you yourself supplying them, Captain.
Thank you. something to tell you. While you're out there, if you see anything that looks like it could be used to make a wheelchair, bring it back, will you? It's for Chris. He'll be stuck in bed all the time if he doesn't get a wheelchair. Thanks. Oh, and don't mention this to anyone.
Approaching target. Continue to search the area. Objective complete. Please return at once.
Now that the wormhole digger has commenced operation, we are able to obtain an extremely pure form of Guban energy, known as Iris energy. Finally, one piece of good news to go along with all of the disappointments. We've managed to make progress with our investigation. We sent out a unit on a scouting mission, and they reported finding a rather large creature during their patrol. I checked the logs, and they seem to match the exact time the anomalies were detected by the crew's instruments. According to Virgil's reports, there was a large amount of Guban energy detected as well. It might just turn out to be a new species of Wanderer. The combat team referred to the creature as the Lord of Dust. It appeared out of nowhere and then vanished just as fast. It must be moving via a wormhole. That would explain the abnormal readings from our instruments. It makes me wonder just how much Guban energy it would take to instantly transport such a massive being. We need to find out more about this Lord of Dust. That means considerably expanding the area we explore. Additionally, our research into the dust has progressed well, enabling us to form a new hypothesis on its link to the Wanderers. However, if our hypothesis is correct... No. Never mind.
Since we arrived on this world, we have come across numerous castaways. Unlike us, they seem to have come here after getting caught up in a naturally occurring wormhole. After hearing their stories, there is one thing we know with certainty. Although they are from different eras, we all came from the same Earth. Their history and dates of major incidents all correlated perfectly with ours, which means these wormholes can extend through time itself. If that's true, maybe it means we can return to our own time as well. Did Top Brass know about this? And if they did, does that mean that they sent us here anyway? What about Chloe? Did she know? Were we sent out on this recovery mission despite them knowing the dangers posed by the Wanderers? Unfortunately, I have no answers. Only more questions. At least we have a bit of good news. I met somebody interesting among the castaways we've come across. A soldier with considerable knowledge and experience. He served in a mercenary group back home. He came from the year 1975. That's right, the same year that we were sent on our mission. He said the facility that they were using, he referred to it as Mother Base, came under attack, and he was sucked into a wormhole that suddenly appeared. He couldn't stop worrying about his friends and his partner that tried to save him. He really is one of the good guys. He's quite older than I am, but we think a lot alike, making it easy to talk to him. When I'm with him, I just feel my thoughts fall into place more easily, and before I know it, we're in the middle of a deep conversation. I'm not a fan of the missions they assign us, but I feel like his presence will help me get through them.
Thank you.
your stamina. You should rest before you're out of gas.
To analyze the data. Please synchronize your iDroid with me here.
Captain, we repaired the materials you brought back and took a shot at making a wheelchair. This kind of thing isn't my forte, but thanks to Reeve's help, we pulled it off. Maybe he's not such a bad guy after all, huh? Anyway, I'm gonna go give it to Chris. What do you think, Chris? I know it's not perfect, but...
No, it's fine. It's great, actually. Thank you.
Captain. Pardon the interruption.
The data you recovered contained records of the Karen Corps.
It looks as though we may have to rely on Mr. Gruen's data after all.
How'd that wheelchair work out?
It's functioning with no issues whatsoever.
What? You were the one who came up with the idea?
Damn it, Virgil, I told you to keep your mouth shut. Oh, well. I do have another suggestion, though.
We don't know how long it'll take to finish analyzing what we got from Gruen. So I was thinking we should set up an exploration team to help secure supplies.
Good idea. We'll get home sooner with the right people working in the right places. We've got Chris to think about, too.
If you're going to be forming this team, I can help out with that.
Are you kidding me?
I'm serious. Of course I don't mean I'll be able to go out and look myself, but I can provide support. I took a look at Virgil's operating system. I noticed there are a bunch of features with limiters and locks on them. I won't be able to unlock everything at once, but I think I can bring the navigation features back online pretty quick.
If Chris can do this, you'll be able to set multiple navigation points at once. This would certainly be just what an exploration team would need.
That'd be awesome, but...
Well, programming gave me a world to explore.
Yeah, I can understand that. And now, thanks to you, our exploration team will be equipped for the job.
All right, then. We're going to... I leave that to... Construct the specified facility at the base camp. If you lack any of the required materials, you'll need to gather those as well. It's going to take a little longer to finish going through Gruen's data. In the meantime, just a moment. I've intercepted a new radio transmission. Have a listen.
Moi, anyone respond? Need some help here! Got these monsters on my ass!
Sounds like another castaway. Go and rescue him.
Situation report updated. Check your iDroid for details.
It's incredible. Plants can even grow in a place like this.
transporter and expand the area you can search.
Thank you.
Supply yourself with oxygen by using Kuban energy.